Lawrence. Nielsen took a hit. The knock gets over the line. There's a penalty. Nielsen is down. Uh-oh.
That's Martina going after Gavrik.
Everybody has picked a man. The two goaltenders are staying in the blue ice at the moment. Everybody, including the referees and the two linesmen, gathered right in front of the penalty box. Lawrence Nielsen was hammered, I mean hammered, from behind. Had his arm up, Butch indicating the penalty immediately. Let's take another look.
There's Franz and there's Gavrik as he pushes him in. And again, you can see that Franz Nielsen hit his head against the boards. Watch this, bang. There goes the head first. And Gavrik's liable to get five in game for that hit from behind, Jake. And then now the melee starts loose. And you can see Gavrik leans that shoulder into him. And anytime you have your back to the play, you leave yourself open. And we'll see what Gavrik gets. So it looks like he's only going to get two, or at least initially, as he's sitting in the box. Franz is on one knee, so he seems to be not too bad, although we'll wait and see as he gets to the dressing room and the trainers take a look at him.
Garrett Timms was in the building this morning, out of his head trainer, who had that hamstring problem. Achilles problem after a little basketball incident in Tampa. So Nato is going to take Franz to the dressing room and attend to him there.
Yeah, at least he's skating off under his own power. But watch Franz, he loses the puck, stops. And then Gavrik leans a strong shoulder into him. And you can see Franz hit his head right on the glass. Watch his head, as you can see, it just goes right in and right there just above the dasher. And boy, he looks like he's out on his feet there just for a second, Jake. So you can just see him down there, although he is moving right away. And of course, Radek Martina comes in right away to rescue.
So this will be part of that new eating, right? Where he has to go to the room. Yeah, good call on the part of the National Hockey League. The trainers, it's a certain period of time. There's a protocol here now where they've beaten them four straight after the Islanders have won the opening game of the season. Between the two, Cross taken to the boards. Haven't got him, and now at the blue line, we've got a scrap.
That's Dubinsky and Jack Helen, and that's Dubinsky quite a bit bigger than Helen. Give Helen credit standing up and trying to stay involved.
Dubinsky, I presume, taking exception to Helen Chipchak. Across down the goal for the wrestling situation now.
Now Jack Helen, a couple of cross checks earlier on in that particular shift, but the Islanders we talked about are not going to back up.
We'll step out. Islanders 4, Rangers 1.
Islanders lead 4-1 over the Rangers. It has been a rockin' sock'em game. Watch this tip check by Helen as he upends Prusk. Well, it doesn't stop there as this play would continue. Dubinsky looking to even the score as these two would go at it. Little cross-checking, little slashing. Okay, let's go at it. And away they go, Jigs. Little fisticuffs action. And there's the Islander fans talking to Dubinsky. And well, the Ranger fans are here also. Dubinsky jersey.
And right back to him. Runs it out into the center ice zone. Mark Kadek over the line. Gave it to Martin. His shot is on. Johnson the save. Another fight out in the center ice area. Jack Killen involved again.
No, that's Haley.
Oh, that's Haley, yeah.
Haley and Avery. Oh, no, Haley's one tough customer and loves to go. So far, they're just hanging on to one another. Bleeding from his left eye. Not sure where he got that from, whether that was a punch or not. But you can see the blood coming from Avery.
Eagle Eye Eric Hornick says that Avery challenged Kavanagh, and Haley jumped in. Haley and Avery.
Here comes Haley on the ice. There's. Look at that, they just jump right in. Oh, there's a couple of good rights by Haley, and that's where Avery was cut over that left eye. Haley landed a couple of quick punches, and good for Haley jumping in to help his team out, the young 20-year-old Travis Hamonic. And Haley, we've seen, can really fight. I mean, I talked about him reminding
me out of Como, a step up from Josh Bailey, full season from Oposo. Here we go again. Another bad stop.
That's Konopkin, trust.
Konopkin, of course, leading the league in penalty minutes. There are guys with more fights than Z, though.
Just get to Lixon because the game's over, I guess, Jake. I'm not sure this is really necessary. The Rangers have a few more games to play in the playoff run, and the Islanders have a few more games, but these two are determined to go at it. They're throwing some hard punches. And again, a lot of frustration pented up between both of these clubs.
Didn't take long for Konopka to get one in last night's game, but Clarkson did it.
I wanted to get that one out of the way early.
And Matty Barkman, Leach followed it up. And this one was Clarkson.
No worse for the wear. As I don't think either one of the guys landed anything too dramatic. You see Konopka, he's coming in. And they're just, there's no doubt about that. Those two guys wanted to go at it. They didn't need to get much involved.
Let's see, when's the next division game? Multiple fights.
That might be Pittsburgh the next time there's a division game. And that was quite a battle last time here at the Coliseum. I wonder if anything...
On the property of the New York Islanders, race out of Pittsburgh. The puck on the boards, and they're allowed to play it. The Islanders do, and it's Josh Bailey. Around behind the net, Travis Hamonic. Joensuu, a little pushing and shoving, why not? And it'll turn into a full-fledged scrap. Dylan Reese. Oh, he's on the receiving end early and then decides to unload. He's got a tackle.
He's got to shake that helmet loose. He's caught up on his arm. Now he can start throwing some punches. And a little takedown WWF style.
3 minutes and 9 seconds left in regulation time. Just a good look at Dylan Reese, and he'll just head for the dressing room.
Now, a good place to have a fight, right by the corner where the door is. It's a quick exit. Hedotenko and Reese getting at it. You watch the two of them. There's Hedotenko with his elbow up a little high, and Reese took exception to that. And then they start pushing at one another, and they wait for each other to get their gloves off, and away they go. Well, it looks like the referee is talking over there to Jack Capuano. Some words of advice, possibly. And Tortorella, as you can see, not too happy. Sarcastic smile, kind of. Not the type of game he expected his team to play today, that's for sure, Jake. So it was an important game for these guys, and only time will tell whether it's going to cost them a playoff spot.
Whose attention is he trying to get on the Islander bench? Do you want to engage Jack in a conversation? Is that it?
I don't know.
You're watching the Foxwoods Final Five no matter what. Go to foxwoods.com for special offers or to pre-register for your Dream Rewards card.
Well, I think he's upset because the Islanders have their power play on with Tavares and Molson and Parenteau. And the game is 6-1, so I think that's what irking Tortorella is saying. Hey, you won the game. You beat us already. There's no reason. Sneaks by. And one of the last guys you talk about, Preston. He came through the Gomez trade via the Higgins through Calgary. So, you know, a lot of times you make trades, you don't see the immediate results, but you do there. Yeah, well, they're going to make sure there's no fights going on here late. As the game is over. I mean, it's 6-2, and the referees are just making sure there isn't any late shenanigans, Jake. So, a lot of times, and just alerting the fans that a lot of these things that happen, you don't see the immediate results. But for the Rangers, with McDonough, Preston, Sauer, all been great acquisitions, and much like Garceau has done via the trade and waiver draft, both these GMs have done a good job.
We mentioned earlier in this period that Ty Wishart had gone to the dressing room, has not returned, and now we're learning that it's a shoulder injury. We're going to have one more pop before this is over. Matt Button got his chance with Dubinsky, but the officials in between them quickly. Well, boys will be boys.
Yeah, that's Konopka with Boyle, and they're just going to push these guys right off the ice right away. And delaying the inevitable, which is a win for the Islanders. And now it's just 8 seconds left. And again, everybody's a little bit frustrated, particularly the Rangers. I mean, the Islanders are elated. Watch Matt Martin and Brandon Dubinsky. There's a little bit of a hook, and they're just pushing and shoving at one another. No one's going to back down, and both of them are ready combatants. And at this point in time, you just really want to just have the game end. As coaches, certainly John Tortorella doesn't want to see any kind of suspensions. He's got four big games coming up, and Jeff Capuano is feeling pretty good about his hockey club. As you mentioned, Jigs, they played pretty well the other night in the Devils, and they've come out with a real strong effort against the New York Rangers. I mean, you would expect them to be ready to play.